And now I invite Ba Sein from Rohingya Blogger to deliver some testimony. Ba Sein is originally from Mongdor in northern Rakhine State, where the most recent outbreak of violence has taken place.
Thank you. Honorable dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to speak here. I am Ba Sein. I was born in Budinong Township of Arkana State, Western Burma in 1952. My father was a civil servant, and I myself worked for the Ministry of Cooperative in my hometown until 1991. I now live as a Rohingya exile and a refugee in the United Kingdom. I will share with my first-hand eyewitness account of the first centrally organized large-scale attack against our Rohingya communities across Arkan or Rakhine State in 1978. The attack was widely and correctly understood to be ordered and orchestrated by the highest level of the leadership in the central government of ex-General Niue in Rangoon. It was launched as a part of a migration crackdown known as Nagami or King Dragon Operation. After the independence of Burma, Rohingya people were the same as the ethnic groups in Burma, and they enjoyed the right of full citizenship. National registration card, NRC, were issued for the first time in 1952. All Rohingyas in Arkana State were holders of NRC card. But in 1974, additional remark was sealed on the NRC card stating that holding this certificate should not be considered as a conclusive proof of as citizenship. In the same year, the government launched Sebe or Jasmine Operation. The operation was designed to seize the NRC card from the Rohingya people. Many thousands of Rohingya NRC cards of the Rohingya were confiscated without any legal notice. In the beginning of 1977, the Burmese regime initiated King Dragon Operation at the cost of $140 million, $20 million US. The official purpose was to update government's demographic database in Arkan or register all residents classified categorically as either Burmese citizen or foreigners. But in reality, the operation wasn't as it official was said to be. It turned out one central objective was to take away all documents and proof of citizen that were in the hands of Rohingya families. Consequently, virtually all Rohingyas were made illegal in our own towns and villages of birth. I saw with my own eyes teams of Burmese and Rakhine local authorities confiscating official ID cards from those who had them and arresting and taking away anyone with their handcuff, including young children who were not yet eligible for ID card. As a junior township level government staff, I traveled through many towns in Arkana State. I saw with my own eyes many unusual things at the various checkpoints. For instance, at the checkpoint, only Rohingyas, not other ethnic groups in Arkan or Rakhine State, were routinely questioned. Often, we were both verbally and physically abused by Burmese and Rakhine officials, from private in the army to police officer to magistrate. Even when we were walking down the street, they would stop us and ask who we were, what our lumio or race was. Many Rohingyas who say they are Rohingya get beaten and slapped, abused by their security troop. I know this for the effect. Both local Rakhine and Burmese authorities would call us Rohingya by the derogatory terms, Khoto or Kla, this meaning nigger. The operation started in Akyaf, the capital of Arkan, on the 8th February 1978. Some of 250 inter-government officials started in King Dragon operation in Kiev. They were said to be dispatched from Rangoon, the then capital. And also a large number of the heavily armed force from Burma Army and Navy in Arkan State, as well as the Civil Administration Department. I also saw thousands of Rakhine members from the Burma Socialist Program Party roaming about alongside security and other officials. At the launch of this operation, this man entered the large Rohingya village in Aikyaf or Sitwe called Sakipara. My own relatives in Aikyaf informed me that 1,734 Rohingyas were herded like animals onto the army trucks and taken to the Aikyaf central jail in a single evening. In Aikyaf alone, more than 5,000 Rohingyas, including elderly men and women, children, women, were detained without any reason, without a few days. I heard many first-hand stories of how Burmese army terrorized our Rohingya communities by want on killing and rape and gang rape Rohingya women throughout the Rohingya pockets. The mass grove of Burmese officials and Rakhine locals were seen carrying out the destruction of mosques, business, and Rohingya homes, just like what they did more recently, June and October 2012. The people who got arrested were inhumanly tortured. Even elderly men and women, children were not spared. In my hometown, Butidong, here is what I saw. On 11 February, the Burma Navy brought the team to launch operation in Butidong and Mongdo Township, where a majority of Rohingya live. The team appeared in every wards and villages. Rohingya were rounded up. I saw with my own eyes this Dragon operation unit arrest Rohingyas tied with hand with ropes, stung them along with raw like hearts of goats. My neighbor, school teacher Umir Ahmad and wife have national registration card, but their teenage children were arrested because they could not produce ID card. They were not old enough to apply for ID card. Most of the innocent detainees were kept in the open field under bright sun. Butidong police station and jails were overflowing with the Rohingyas detainees. All men, women, and children were together in the field with no food and sanitation or toilet facilities. An immigration court was established inside the main police station in Butidong. Burmese and Rakhine authorities questioned the detainees. Neither nor witness were allowed any of the court hearing. With a few exceptions, detainees were given a long-term prison with hard labor. Subsequently, many of them were sent to the prison in Mongdo, the Rohingya town closest to Bangladesh and Aikyaf township. Large number of prisoners were crammed in the small cell. Many families perished in this inhuman and unhygienic jail cell. They were provided with extremely insufficient quantity of goods, no medical treatment, and many were died with various diseases and reported many were tortured and dead. I am not only Rohingya eyewitness who lived through the King Dragon operation in 1978. There were many people in different towns, wards, and villages of also witnessed in torture, arrest, and inhumanity during the large-scale operation against Rohingya. So widespread among Rohingya's community and people began panic run. Rohingya left their land, properties, house, their cattle, and virtually anything that was not movable, just tried to run for their life. I saw with my eyes Rohingya men with several bullet injuries who was being carried to our town hospital. Nobody could save him. He died before reaching the hospital. Using my civil ID card, I was able to sneak into the hospital and took his picture as he laid in the mortuary. I saw with my own eyes that how they abuse the people while so-called collecting the population data. They entered the house, asked the name and age, then started slap and punching Rohingya without any reason. Many Rohingyas watched or heard story of how their mother, sister's wife and wife were raped and gang raped by the Burmese authority and security unit. Panic stricken, the people from the town of Brugdidong fled to throw the Nachingdok Valley, then throw the Chigambi in Mongno Township, then they fled to the Bangladesh by crossing Naf River. I followed with them through the valley to observe the situation. I took picture of fleeing people. Unfortunately, my picture were lost forever some years later when the Rohingya activist organization in Bangladesh, which I gave, was raided by Bangladeshi police, which confiscated everything in the office, including my picture. The three-month-long dragon operation drove out roughly about 200,000 Rohingya from the various pockets, including Akyaf, Mongdo, and Budidong Township. After the King Dragon operation, the regime launched Hinta operation or Scared Duck operation in order to bring back the Rohingya from the Bangladesh. According to the Rohingya government figures, about 170,000 Rohingyas returned in late 1979. Rohingya refugees were thus received through a dozen or so temporary screening camps along the Burmese-Bangladesh border. They were issued a certificate after verification their status documents, although the government labeled Rohingyas as illegal Bengali immigrants. On the certificate, the words Rohingya was written, the ethnic name Rohingya was clearly written in the certificate. Those were issued by the Ministry of Home Affairs. However, this new certificate said Rohingya were a citizen or national registration card holders anymore, in spite of the fact that they referred to their previous NRC numbers. None of the Rohingya who previously were NRC or citizen card holders were issued back their NRC card. In 1982, new citizenship law was enacted. The Rohingya became stateless according to their customized law. Again, in 1991 and 1992, post-socialist military regime led by the Somong and Than Shwe launched another operation as a similar scale as the 1978 Dragon Operation. Consequently, about 250,000 Rohingyas fled Northern Arkham, unlike 1978. These Rohingya were never allowed to return to Burma. Starting from 1989, the military regime launched a program in a nation replaced an NRC card with national scrutiny card. All the Rohingyas in the Arkham were asked to submit the application. The application were officially submitted, but in 1992, all Rohingya in Arkham State were forced to hold temporary registration card, which is especially issuing for non-citizenship, instead of issuing them national security card. Even the NRC card from the government staff were confiscated, and they were forced to hold temporary registration card in late 1994. After forcing the Rohingya to hold temporary registration card more than 20 years, the government has confiscated them in early 2015. And today, new democratic government led by the Aung San Suu Kyi is forcing Rohingya to hold national verification card, NVC, which Rohingya do not want. The card itself is unlawful. Yet there are many operation against the Rohingya to hold this card. The government started blocking the roads, villages, arresting prominent figures from the villages. However, the majority of Rohingya are not going to accept this card, which will make them foreigners permanently. for the reason of the Rohingya will be suffering from new restriction imposed every day by the Aung San Suu Kyi-led government. In conclusion, we are citizen and ethnic community from Burma, but today are mislabeled by Burmese government as illegal Bengalis. The Burmese government began their official persecution of us, Rohingya, four decades ago. The Rohingya suffering did not begin in 2012, where Burma opened up the war to the world, one of the most remaining economies to do business with. We experienced many waves of massacre before 2012. Unlike 2012, in the last year, October 9, after attacking three border guard police force by a group of Rohingya fighters, the government launched clearance operation. At least 1,000 Rohingya civilians were inhumanly killed. Many hundreds of young girls, women are raped. A few thousand houses were burned down by military and border guard police. We are ourselves, as the sons and daughters of the Northern Arakan, just like Buddhist Rakhine, who make up 2/3 of Arakan's population, our identity was ancestral. It is our responsibility to honor our foreparents by keeping there our distinct identity as Rohingya. But we are facing similar situation just like Jews in Nazi Germany, which stripped German Jews of their nationality. Our suffering is not caused simply by sectarian or communal strife between us and Rakhine extremists. The Burmese military leadership 1970s have been centrally involved in the attempt to erase our ethnic identity and eradicate our literal present from our ancestral land. Please listen our cries. Please help end the persecution. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Questions from the panel?
I'd like to ask you one question. Thank you so much. Just a small point. You said that the national verification card is unlawful.
Yeah.
I'd like you to say a little more about that. Why?
I am not a lawyer, but I know the many articles I saw there is written everywhere in the internet or everywhere. In 1982 law, there is no verification card. There is no mention any verification card. This is making government for the bluffing for to the our Rohingya people to make something they are making.
I understand that at one time a number of Rohingya lived in the Rangoon or Yangon area, and presumably other parts of Burma or Myanmar. Is that situation completely now changed? Is the entire population of Rohingya established only on that border area with Bangladesh?
Only border area.
So people were removed from Rangoon. When was that?
The government not allowed to move Rangoon. They are making like open prison in the Northern Arakan area.
No, I understand, but if you go back 50, 100 years or so, I understand there was a population in Rangoon. Is that not correct?
There is only few, I think the very few population there. There is going, there's not much Rohingya there.
There are still some Rohingya in Rangoon.
Yeah, I just wondering, but in the past there was a bigger population. So this is a long process of driving people back into this one sort of western corner of the country.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Can I have something on that point? Actually,
you better
what
get
you mentioned is the Rohingya population mostly living in western part of Burma. So what you mean in after general naming coup power, there is some Indians in Rangoon and other parts. So by
by doing some operation, he driven out many people. But Rohingyas, some Rohingyas are still in Rangoon, but they cannot say they are Rohingya. So just for the some yes. reason, they just live there. It is not actually their focus is mostly in northern Arkana state, where the largest Muslim population of Rohingya people, Muslim population of Burma are residing in western part of Burma. So that is the policy. Thank you.
Any other questions? Okay, thank you. And now I'll call on Dokin Lwa.